Aisha is a young little girl, 5 years of age, with deformity of the spine since birth and also the deformity of the right foot. This is how her x-ray looked when she presented to us. You can see the severe kyphoscoliosis. This is scoliosis of over 90 degrees and this is the kyphosis of over 110 degrees. These were the side bending views which showed that the deformity was completely rigid and not moving. At this age, the options are very few, which involve either a use of webter or growing rods. But the severity of the Cobb angle was prohibiting us to do any one of these two surgeries. So the next best option was a risky one, but that is the CT scan of the child, which shows the spine looking like a snake. So we planned a vertebral column resection surgery, which has got a 10% risk of morbidity and mortality, wherein you remove the spinal column from all around the spinal cord, correct the deformity and fix it up with rods on both sides. You can see this is the spine after it was exposed. You can see that acute 90 degree bend of the spine, and this is at the end of surgery, wherein it was reduced to less than 30 degrees. And these are the intraoperative navigation images, which show exact direction of screws and the amount of angulation that has to be corrected. And the neuromonitoring continuously will monitor the neural function in both the lower limbs so that risk of paralysis is reduced to less than 1%. So this is her post-op radiograph, which shows the degree of correction. You can see that the kyphosis is corrected to nearly less than 10% and scoliosis is corrected to nearly less than 10% again. And the child was walking on her feet overall. Cheers to Manipal Hospital, Bangalore. Thank you.
So my child is okay, though she cannot walk now. After 6 weeks, she'll be able to walk very well. But the back is okay, and everything is okay.
Aisha was a cute 5-year-old girl from Nigeria. She had a crooked foot and ankle. This was detected at birth, treated initially with a few plasters and a small surgery, but the deformity recurred and kept getting worse, as it appears before the surgery, but it appeared quite bent, something shaped like a bean. The inner border of the foot was very bent and rigid. The outer border was also curved, and she used to walk on her tippy toes because the ankle was bent downwards. The surgery was planned for her. I planned to tackle all the things in one go and deal with all the tight structures. So in her surgery, I approached the ankle from all the three sides, the inside, the outside and the behind. All the tighter structures were released, all the tight muscles were lengthened, both on the backside and on the inside, and a small cut was made in the bone on the outer border of the foot. Once this was done, the correction was maintained with the help of wires, one on the outer border of the foot, one on the inner border of the foot, and one through the heel all the way up to the leg bone. This is how her foot looked at the end of the surgery. With absolutely no pressure from me, the inner border of the foot is looking very nice. The outer border of the foot is also looking straight, and the heel is looking neutral. Once this complete correction was achieved, she was put in a plaster which extended to above the knee. This plaster was maintained for a period of 6 weeks. So going through her x-rays, these are the three wires that are seen, one through the inner border of the foot, one through the outer border of the foot, and one through the ankle. As you see, the correction of the foot is very well maintained. This is the x-ray through the other view. This also shows that the correction of the foot is very well maintained, both in the straight line, the outer border of the foot, as well as in the inner border of the foot. Her plaster will be changed after 6 weeks, after which she will be allowed to walk. She will not require any shoes after that, and I am quite sure that she'll recover very well from this complicated surgery.